أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه would protect the secret of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. The daughter of Umar bin Khattab رضي الله عنه, Hafsa, was married to one of the Sahaba who has fought in the Battle of Badr. Later on he died. So Umar bin Khattab رضي الله عنه wanted his daughter to marry from the best. So he went to Uthman ibn Affan and he offered his daughter to him. He told Uthman ibn Affan رضي الله عنه, do you want to marry my daughter Hafsa? Uthman ibn Affan رضي الله عنه said, let me think about it. He later on came back and said, قد بدا لي ألا أتزوج يومي هذا. I've decided that I don't want to marry at this particular time. I'm not interested in marriage now. Umar bin Khattab رضي الله عنه might have disliked that a little bit. So he went to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه and he told him, I'm offering you my daughter if you want to marry her. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه did not respond. Didn't say anything. Umar bin Khattab said, I was even more upset with Abu Bakr than I was with Uthman. At least Uthman came and gave me an answer, even though it was a no answer, but at least he gave me an answer. But Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه was silent. I offer my daughter to him, he doesn't give me an answer. A few days later, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم marries Hafsa. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه, after the marriage, he came to Umar bin Khattab and said, I think that you were upset with me because I didn't give you an answer. He said, yes, I was upset with you. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه said, the reason why I didn't respond back is because I heard Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم mention her. And I wasn't going to be the one who would disclose the secret of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. And if he did not marry her, I would have married her. So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه said, I felt that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, by mentioning her name, was interested in her. And that's why I kept quiet, to wait and see what will happen. If Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم does not marry her, I would have married her. But I am not going to be the one who will disclose the secret of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. Rasulullah صلوات الله وسلامه عليه wanted to have a relationship, a marriage relationship with the four Sahaba رضي الله عنهم. So you find that he married the daughter of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and he married the daughter of Umar al-Faruq. And then he married two of his daughters to Uthman ibn Affan. First he married him one and then when she passed away he married him the other. And there's a statement that says, Allah Alam how strong the narration is, but if I had 99 daughters, I would marry them to Uthman. If one of them died, I will keep on marrying him. That is how much love Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم had for Uthman ibn Affan رضي الله عنه. And then he married his daughter Fatima to Ali ibn Abi Talib. So now Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم has a relationship, family relationship with the four Khulafa رضي الله عنه. Two things here to note. Number one, marriage in those days was very easy. Very easy. Now we have complicated marriage so much, we have placed so much bureaucracy in marriage, that unfortunately haram became easier than halal. In the time of the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, things were very simple. First of all, the nature of the Sahaba, as Abdullah ibn Mas'ud says, كانوا أقل الناس تكلفا. They were the least superficial among people. They hated complications. And they lived a very simple life. And they loved simplicity. They were the furthest from complication or sophistication. The Sahaba رضي الله عنهم were simple in their dress, simple in their food, simple in their furniture, simple in their houses, simple in everything. And they cherished and they loved that simplicity. It's not like that's all what they knew. No, Umar bin Khattab says, I have knowledge about all of these fancy dishes and food. But this is how I want to live. I want to live simplicity. It's not due to ignorance. They viewed that as the better way. So marriage was very simple. And you can notice that Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu is offering his daughter. Who would do that today? Who would go to somebody whom they know is a good person, a righteous person, a brother who is in need of marriage, and would tell them, I would offer you my daughter. Who would do that now? They would think that it's shame, it's embarrassing, it's not good, it's lowering your status. But Umar ibn Khattab didn't have a problem with that. He went and he offered his daughter to Uthman, he offered her to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, because he wants the best for his daughter. And in those days, because marriage was so simple and easy, there wasn't anything called an unmarried woman, which is called in Arabic, unusa, women who are unmarried, who are deprived from the blessing of marriage. In those days, there was a rule that you take care of every woman in the society. Every woman would be taken care of. So one of the purposes of polygamy was so that the whole society is taken care of. Nobody is left out of this important relationship. Because Allah Azza wa Jal has created us in pairs. Azwaja. And it's part of the nature of the man and woman to be in such a relationship. So therefore no one in the society would be left out and deprived of this. And Rasulullah ﷺ told the ones who wanted to choose a different path that this is not my sunnah. The ones who wanted to practice a life of celibacy and get away from marriage because they heard that this was the practice of the Christian monks, Rasulullah ﷺ said, this is not my sunnah, this is not my way. My way is the way of marriage. And whoever doesn't follow my way doesn't belong to me. So marriage in Islam is ibadah. It's a form of worship. And we please Allah Azza wa Jal through it. So I would like to urge all the parents to make marriage easy so that they can keep their boys and girls away from haram. In the time of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, halal was easier than haram. Haram was very difficult. To commit haram was very difficult. But the path of halal was very easy. However, now things, especially in Western societies, every haram is available, and it's not only available, it's promoted. Because we are living in times when good is evil and evil is good. So this is something that the Muslim families need to break these rigid traditions that don't belong to Islam. And subhanAllah, as the scholars say, every bid'ah replaces the sunnah. Everything wrong is only there because it has uprooted something that was right. Therefore, we should go back to the way of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum of making things simple and encouraging halal. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنَ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمُ الْبَاءَ فَلَيْتَزَوَّجِ. Marriage should be done in an early age. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make it easy on our brothers and sisters who are seeking marriage, and to make halal an open door for them, and to close the doors of shaitan in their faces.